I'm Jukka Suomela, Associate Professor in Computer Science at Aalto University. My own research area is algorithms, logic, and complexity. And a lot of our research boils down to this. We want to understand what can be computed efficiently. We want to understand both the possibilities and limitations of all kinds of computers. As we can see all around us, what modern computers can do for us has been advancing rapidly. The mobile phone in your pocket can do things we couldn't do even with supercomputers just a couple of decades ago. And this is thanks to advances on two fronts: hardware and software. We keep getting better computers, and we keep getting better computer programs running on those computers. Hardware is getting faster all the time. Modern computers can already do thousands of billions of calculations every second. And computer scientists keep discovering clever algorithms that solve all kinds of challenging problems. And thanks to the new algorithms, even our old computers can do more than ever before. And this combination of progress in hardware and software is what has turned, for example, DNA sequencing, internet search engines, real-time 3D graphics, and speech recognition from science fiction to parts of everyday life. But what are the limitations of all of this? Can we just sit down and wait for a few years and expect that all the problems that are currently still far beyond the reach of current computers will be something your mobile phone can do soon? Or are there some fundamental limitations that we can't overcome? As I said, advances in computing come in two very different forms: faster hardware and more clever software. And it turns out that the fundamental limitations also come in two very different forms. Hardware is, in the end, limited by the laws of physics. For example, there is no way to exceed the speed of light. This is already very clearly visible, for example, in the global internet. Sending a message from a computer in Finland to a computer in, let's say, New Zealand, and getting an answer back will always take more than 100 milliseconds, no matter what kind of technology we use. Now, software has also got its own limitations. But those limitations don't come from physics. They come from the mathematical laws of computation. And these are the laws of nature that I am studying. We know that many tasks are computationally easy. They are efficient algorithms for solving them. Even an old computer can solve them easily. And for many tasks, their computational complexity is still wide open. We don't know if better algorithms exist for them or not. We haven't yet found a clever way to solve them fast, but there's still hope. Maybe next year someone comes up with an amazing idea, thanks to which we will be able to solve them much faster than with the programs that we use nowadays. But we also know that many tasks are computationally hard. We know that we have reached the limits. It is not just that we haven't yet figured out how to solve them fast. These are mathematical facts. It is not possible to solve them fast with computers, no matter what kind of programs you use. And these are the mathematical laws of nature that we study in theoretical computer science. We discover faster and faster algorithms for solving problems. But we also simultaneously discover more and more about the limitations of computers. There's always something computers cannot do. There are problems we would like to solve, but even the fastest supercomputers won't be able to help with that. So, what are these very hard problems? It turns out that many of them are related to our own field, computing. Designing algorithms, writing computer programs, and checking that computer programs are written correctly. These are all challenging tasks for human beings. But it turns out that they are also challenging tasks for computers. And this is also an example of the research questions that we are right now studying here at Aalto. We explore what are the opportunities for using computers in the study of computer science itself, and what are questions there that cannot be solved efficiently with computers, no matter how clever programs we try to write. My own research group is working on these questions in the context of distributed and parallel computing, where we seek to understand what are tasks that can be solved efficiently in large computer networks or with massively parallel supercomputers. Here is just one example of many distributed algorithms that we have designed here at Aalto using computers. This algorithm that I've illustrated here takes care of the synchronization of many computers in a highly fault-tolerant manner. So, to conclude, fast computers and fast computer networks are something our whole society is heavily relying on these days. And a solid understanding of what we can do with computers efficiently is the foundation for all of that. And this is what we are studying and teaching here at Aalto.